everyone, my name is Iris Franz, and today we're going to talk about the welfare effect of a tariff. And we're going to start with a small country example because it is easier to understand. So we're going to start the story by a country that is under autarky, meaning this country is not trading with any other country. So if you're not trading with any other country, then you have to consume whatever you produce. So let's start by looking at the local demand curve. So DD is the local demand curve. The small d stands for domestic. And SD stands for local supply curve. And the small d stands for domestic. And we know the intersection of demand curve and supply curve will be able to find the equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity without trade. So equilibrium price is PA. A stands for autarky. And QA, A stands for autarky. So that will be the equilibrium price and quantity. And we can look at the welfare of consumers by looking at consumer surplus. So consumer surplus will be the area below the demand curve, above the price paid by the consumer, and the base of the triangle will be from zero to the quantity demanded in the market. And in this example is QA. So our consumer surplus is triangle FG. PA. What about the welfare to the producers? Then we look at producer surplus, which is the area below the price received by the producer, above the supply curve, and the base of the triangle is from zero to the quantity supplied in the market, and in this case, it's QA. So producer surplus under autarky will be triangle PA, G, J. So that's the consumer surplus, and that's the producer surplus without trade. And now suppose our country is going to open for trade, and the international price or world price for shoes is PW. That's way lower than PA. So foreigners are going to, or foreign producers are going to sell their shoes at price PW to our country. And given that price being so low, PW, what is our quantity demanded locally? Then we need to look at our local demand curve. So at price PW, what is our quantity demanded? You look at the demand curve, that's right here. So quantity demanded will be QD1. How about quantity supplied locally? Given the price being so low, the local producers are only willing and able to produce QS1. So you can see that quantity demanded is way higher than quantity supplied, and therefore the difference will be satisfied by imports. So without a tariff, our imports will be QD1 minus QS1. And now we're ready to analyze our welfare of the producers and of the consumers. So we want to look at the welfare of the consumers by looking at consumer surplus. So consumer surplus is the area below the demand curve, above the price paid by the consumer, so right now it's PW with trade and without a tariff, so above PW. And base of the triangle is from zero to the quantity demanded in the market, and now it's QD1. So you can see the consumer surplus has increased quite a bit. The new consumer surplus with trade without a tariff will be area triangle FIPW. So you can see that consumer surplus is this huge triangle. What about producer surplus? Producer surplus is the area below the price received by the producer, now is PW, above the supply curve, and the base of the triangle is from zero to the quantity supplied. So that will be here. So that will be triangle PW, KJ. So you can see that local producers really lose out. Their producer surplus has shrunk quite a bit from that triangle to that tiny triangle. So now suppose the government says that, look, we want to protect local producers because their producer surplus has shrunk quite a bit. So we're going to impose a tariff. So you can import, but if you want to buy imports, you can pay PW to the foreign producers, but then for each unit you import, you also have to pay T dollars to the government. And remember, we are a small country, meaning we are a price taker. So foreign producers, they're still going to sell their product at PW, and our local consumers will have to absorb 100% of that tariff. So given the tariff, the price of shoes has increased to our local consumers from PW dollars to PW plus T dollars, because the consumer will have to pay T dollars to the government. Now, given that new price with the tariff, what is the quantity demanded locally? We look at our demand curve and we can see that quantity demanded is QD2. And what is the quantity produced in this market? Given that price is now PW plus T, local producers are willing and able to produce QS2 pairs of shoes. So you can see that quantity demanded is still higher than quantity supplied, even with tariff. But then you can see the difference is smaller than before, meaning we're going to import less than before. And then we can look at consumer surplus and producer surplus. Consumer surplus is the area below the demand curve, above the price paid by the consumer, so now it's PW plus T. So here. And the base of the triangle is from 0 to the quantity demanded in market, now it's QD2. So the consumer surplus will be triangle F, H, PW plus T. What about producer surplus? Producer surplus is the area below the price received by the producer, and now the producers can receive PW plus T dollars for each pair of shoes because now they are protected by the tariff. And producer surplus is the area below PW plus T, below the price received by the producer, above the supply curve, and the base of the triangle is from 0 to the quantity produced. So that will be QS2. And the area of producer surplus is PW plus T, L, J. So you can see with the tariff protection, now producer surplus has increased from that tiny triangle to this triangle. So it's a little bit bigger than before. So now we know that this tariff will cause consumer surplus to shrink from that big triangle to that smaller triangle. In particular, consumer surplus is going to lose area A, B, C, and D. So it's kind of like we're cutting a piece of pie from the consumers, and we want to know where does this piece of pie go. And we're going to cut the pie into four pieces and illustrate where this pie go. So area A actually goes to the producer. So that area A is being redistributed from consumer surplus to producer surplus. So initially that area A belongs to consumer surplus, and now we cut that piece and give it to the producer. So we call that redistributive effect. How about area C? If you look closely, you will notice that it's actually government tariff revenue. Because after we impose the tariff, our imports has become like this amount, QD2 minus QS2. And for each unit you produce, you have to pay T dollars to the government. And so that's exactly this block, T times imports, that's your area C. And we pay this to the government. And that's not lost, because assuming that the government is not corrupt, the government is going to use this tax money to build some bridges, maybe pave the road. So this area is not lost. We still have it. What is lost is area B and D. And we call D consumption effect, and we call E protective effect. So let's see where this pie went. Because that we lost, that means that we lose this piece of pie. Nobody gets it. It's kind of like you bake a piece of pie, and then when you open the oven, there are two pieces burned in the oven, so nobody can enjoy that. So where did this go? So previously, we're going to look at the consumption effect first. Previously, without tariff, suppose you have a marginal consumer. This guy, his value of the good is between PW and PW plus T. If you remember, demand curve reflects the value of the good to the consumer. So suppose his value is right here, somewhere between PW and PW plus T. Before you impose a tariff, he is willing and able to pay up to V dollars to buy this pair of shoes. So when you have international trade without a tariff, the price is PW and his value is higher than PW. So he will happily go and buy a pair of shoes, paying PW, and enjoy a consumer surplus in the amount of V minus PW. So his consumer surplus, this consumer's consumer surplus, will be equal to V minus PW. That's without tariff. Now, with the tariff, the price of a pair of shoes is now PW plus T, which is higher than his value of that pair of shoes. So he will look at the price tag, that's higher than my willingness to pay, my value of the good, so I'm not going to buy it. So you see, previously he could have purchased a pair of shoes and enjoyed the consumer surplus. Now because the price is higher due to a tariff, he cannot buy this pair of shoes, so he cannot enjoy this consumer surplus anymore. And in fact, another consumer, any consumer here whose value is between PW plus T and PW, they will not buy a pair of shoes anymore because of a tariff. And this block, consumption effect, measures the welfare loss of these consumers who could have buy a pair of shoes, but now they can't. So that piece of pie is burned in the oven. Nobody guessed it. And another piece of that we lost is protective effect, which is area B. That piece of pie is also lost. Nobody guessed it. So how is that? Imagine someone, a seller, whose cost is here. And remember that supply curve reflects the cost of producer. So there's a producer whose cost of producing a pair of shoes is C, somewhere between PW and PW plus T. And when there was no tariff, this producer would not produce that pair of shoes because the local price of a pair of shoes is now PW without a tariff. So this producer will look at the price PW and say, hey, if I produce a pair of shoes, the cost is C, which is higher than PW, but I can only sell the shoes for PW, so I'm not going to produce it. Doesn't make sense. But now, with tariff protection, the local price of a pair of shoes has increased to PW plus T. And this producer's cost, C, is lower than PW plus T. So this producer will produce a pair of shoes and sell it. So in a sense, with tariff, we are using local producers who are less efficient because their cost is C, to replace foreign producers whose cost is lower than PW. Once again, we're using local producers who are less efficient, meaning their cost is C, to replace foreign producers whose cost is lower than PW. And that's just a waste. Imagine, if you want to produce something, you want to use as little resource as possible. So that's more efficient, right? But now, because of tariff, your local producer, his cost is C. He will still produce a pair of shoes and turn around and sell it for PW plus T. So that piece of pie represents that we're using less efficient local producers to produce shoes than buying the shoes from foreign efficient producers. But then you'll say, didn't the producers receive that piece? Well, local producers received that piece A. They didn't receive B. Why not? Look at that. Their cost is C. They sold the shoes for PW plus T, and that will be their producer surplus. But below that area is their cost. So they get some money, and then they keep some money as their producer surplus, and the rest, they pay it. They pay the cost out. So they didn't really get this piece. So that piece is lost. And that piece is lost. So we call them value loss. So that's the effect of the tariff. Typically, economists, we don't mind that if you're cutting a piece of pie from consumers, if we just give it to the producer or we just give it to the government who will build railways or highways for us, we don't mind. What we do mind is that we lost. It's like pieces of pie burned in the oven. It's kind of like your younger sibling, asked to cut a piece of apple pie from yours. And then after you cut a big piece of pie and give it to your younger siblings, your younger sibling took a bite and then dropped the rest. Oops, it's on the floor. That's a waste. And we don't like that we lost. That's the reason. So thanks for watching and good luck with your studying.